We asked the Antiques Roadshow's pop memorabilia expert, Justin Pressland.
When you're looking to see if Take That is going to be the most collectible band over the next 10 years, you have to think that because they were so big with 7 number ones and huge album sales, that a lot of items were mass produced, like the t-shirts and the magazines, and they made millions of these and millions of fans bought them. So unless it is something that maybe wasn't available in the shops that you especially got from a member of Take That, I don't actually think that a lot of this stuff is going to be something you can retire on. If you look at the sales that go through auction houses, it is items like letters from members of, say, the Beatles or the Rolling Stones that actually become hugely valuable. So a letter from, say, Gary Barlow or Mark Owen back in 1990, 1991, thanking you for a fan letter, that is the sort of collectible. If we knew what made some artists more valuable than others, we'd all be collecting the right thing now. But I think you have to look at bands that become historically important in the music industry. And what we have to think about with Take That is how important will their music be seen in 10 or 15 years' time. And that all depends, I think, on how Gary Barlow does in particular and how his songwriting develops over the next 5 years. If you think you've got something that will be a Take That valuable, you must keep it in good condition. It is so important because an item that was mass produced that's in poor condition is not going to be collectible to anyone. Therefore, condition is vital. But also, when you buy something like a t-shirt, don't wear it, don't wash it. You know, you have to keep it in its original cellophane bag. Think about a baseball cap. That would have come with a little tag on it and the price. You've got to keep that on because those are the items in the future that are going to be worth the most amount of money. There aren't many collectors who want dog-eared pieces that you know, loved, I'm sure, but the value of it will not be so good because it's in poor condition.
Oh dear, I think perhaps I better look for Howard's clothes. Thanks very much, Justin. That's all for Electric Circus this week. Next week, Celine Dion learns the British art of tossing pancakes and Baywatch babe Alexandra Paul skids into town. Don't miss Live and Kicking tomorrow morning along with some of Take That's Saturday morning historical highlights.
Music next on BBC Two in Sounds of the 80s.
The 6 o'clock zone.
I've looked forward to this moment.
You'll discover aliens.
You were looking for me?
Space cops. Monsters. Adventure. Action. Action. More action.
Barney Dude.
And desperate bald men.
Has the world gone mad?
5 programs, 1 start time, every week on BBC Two at 6.
Prepare to enter the comedy zone.
Where is this place?
It's you.
Get up to speed for the first show.
A little bit, a little bit,
get back to the future in Red Dwarf.
More trouble in sedentary force.
Clench the joystick with a fist of fun.
Get away from me.
Go away.
Flare your nostrils at the smell of Reeves and Mortimer.
I've never feared
never
the cheese.
Feared.
Why fear the cheese?
Why fear any cheese?
Right, you.
Oh, Philip has touched him!
And with the Fantasy Football League, something funny is happening till Friday night on BBC Two.
Tomorrow's World on BBC One now looks at the latest technology that could help protect police officers and reports on a new fight against cancer. The BBC Two in half an hour, rain-soaked circuits and tough dry terrain put drivers to the test in Top Gear Motorsport. First, BBC Two's Headbanging All the Way to Sounds of the 80s.
Tonight on Sounds of the 80s, Motorhead, ZZ Top, U2, Bruce Springsteen, Bon Jovi, In Excess, The Cult, and The Mission.
Chart Challenge, the program that tests your knowledge of pop.
sprats of one kind or another. And on the program, as usual, we have the boring old has-been who needs the money, the boring young nobody who needs the publicity, and Tim Rice who needs a smack in the mouth. First question. Who is this well-known rock band?
No.
Well, I'll give you a clue.
Yeah.
You're their lead singer. No. All right, well, can you pick this one up, Annie?
So dark, they won't even know your name, and the choice is up.
It was lovely. I enjoyed it thoroughly, and all of them had very nice hair. And I enjoyed his beard.
Yes.
I enjoy anyone who's got a beard. I can't see how you can knock any pop singers with beards.
Pete Murray's an old headbanger, we know.
Well, no, what you asked me about the record, which I will be only too pleased to talk about. If we'd have played that in 1967, I think it would have been just as perhaps as successful as it's going to be today. I like it.
You do.
Bond! recorded by the Doolollies between 2 and 4 on the 7th of January, I think. Lou Walrus, the man who made the Supremes, I think he mixed it. Buddy Lobb, who was the lead singer, he was wearing green underpants and socks. It was in the charts for about 15 and a half weeks, and the first copy of the record was sold to a guy, I think, called Eric.
Yeah, this was recorded originally on Warner Brothers WB1. It was the first song ever released on Warner Brothers Records in the States in March 1960, and it was number one for 8 weeks.
Can you pick this one up, Annie?
Nothing is done with me.
Yeah, hardly surprising, is it, really?
I think I know the answer.
Yeah, surprise, surprise. Too late. Right.
Didn't I? Oh, yeah, I liked it. It was snappy. It had something to say. I think the kids will go for it.
Oh. Well, shall we vote that record, or shall we bother? Because it seems to be obvious, but let's see whether they're going to vote
for
it.
I've got to say something else here. You see, I find it very offensive at the BBC to allow this clip from an old television programme on the Alexis Sale Show. Even having the courtesy of asking our permission. And what I find even more offensive is the way they use these clips out of context just to get cheap laughs.
Thank you.
goodbye from all of us here. Bye. And don't forget, if you've got nothing better to do, like counting bollards or lying in the middle of the fast lane of the M1, then why not join us here on Chart Challenge?
Is she as good as the bottle would suggest?